Brock Sanders, Luis Waldo. Our second fight of the night. Pierce Bellano retired David Frank in the first round. Let's see if we see the second in this one.
Nice chop and leg kick from Sanders. Up the middle with the teep.
Yeah, very close with that teep as well.
Wins a hook and Waldo finds one of his own.
Ooh,
and teep. Needs another teep kick to the face. They're both fighting. They're landing their shots here.
Nice switch kick there by Waldo. Low kick finds its mark. Ooh, deep to the face again.
Sanders is so long, man.
Gotta be careful from Sanders just winging those kicks without setting them up. Waldo spry, trying to step on him with that right hand. Knees up the middle from the clinch. It's a lot of activity for these young fellas.
I think he caught him with that knee there at the end.
Waldo feeling himself, getting offline. Big low kick, finds its mark, overhand right.
Uppercuts
coming.
Uppercuts up the middle.
Waldo is bringing it, he's on one.
And he's able to stuff that last teep kick.
Well, you said it right. He didn't really set it up too many times. He just kept throwing it. Eventually, your opponent's going
to
read that.
It found its mark there. I think we saw it twice, landed straight to the face of Waldo. And that time, he was just a little too close, loses his balance, ends up underneath Luis Waldo.
Looks like Sanders has a single butterfly hook, but Waldo is doing a good job keeping the pressure on him, landing big shots here.
Staying active.
Got to be careful.
Trying to pass that leg, just couldn't quite find the angle, but continuing to land those big shots, and now he has taken Sanders back.
Rushed it just a little bit, almost loses the hook.
Yeah, Sanders is back to his feet.
Again, right there, I think that Sanders, just his build kind of worked to his benefit. Luis Waldo with the mat return, covers the hips. Nice work.
He can get his hooks in now. Sanders hanging onto the arm, which is pretty smart. Don't want to let him get that around your neck.
A big punch is coming from Luis.
Bad spot to be here for Sanders with just under 50 seconds remaining in this first round.
He looks composed, though. He understands this position. I can tell he's got game here. He's going to try to work to ground a leg, beat the bottom leg, and escape the spot. Luis doing a good job of retaining top position, taking mount. Right there, just
a lot of scrambling going on. It looks like Sanders has a guillotine, but Waldo smartly turned the angle on to get out of it.
Sanders comes back no worse for the wear, too. You can tell that he was ready to pop back up and get something back.
Gets a takedown of his own now.
Waldo just scrambles.
And now he has the back to end out the round. See if he can stay on top.
An interesting development here at the end of this first round. It felt like Luis Waldo was in control, and then Sanders gets a takedown of his own. He's the one that finishes in the better position. He landed the bigger shots in that first round without question. That was a pretty tight first round there, guys.
Very, very competitive.
Yeah.
Here's that teep come right up the middle.
Two deep kicks from Sanders that really, you can tell it woke Waldo up, but he did a great job on his feet as well. Landed a lot of big punches. That big knee.
That's a big knee, though.
Something that's pretty high level that both of these guys are doing is as they're breaking, they are winging big strikes, and on multiple occasions, these shots are just barely missing. Look for that to find, maybe find its mark in the second round as they get a little more tired.
I have to give the edge to Waldo in this round. I do feel like despite the two big kicks from Sanders, that he landed the bigger shots on his feet, and he had more of the control time on the ground with such big punches that he landed on the ground as well.
Yeah, I think I've got to give the edge to Waldo there as well. That knee was kind of the equalizer in the round. That was a big knee that landed as they were breaking apart.
Competitive stuff, though. Both guys
very
in this fight.
Yes.
Yeah, I got to give it to Sanders to work his way back into a dominant position before the round ended.
Sharp jab from Sanders to start out round one.
You can tell Sanders really knows his, his range. Goodness. Nice right hand from Sanders.
Looking for that teep kick again, doesn't land. Nice little hook from Waldo.
Both guys exchange a hook and they both get close. I mean, these are some exchanges. Waldo got wobbled there by a big hook. Right hand finds its mark, knee up the middle. Waldo needs to clear the cobwebs, turn it into a grappling match here.
Right onto his back and now into mount. Good stuff here from my Brock Sanders. The tide has certainly turned.
What a turn of momentum there, and it happened so quickly. This is why we tuned into the fights. Beautiful stuff, both guys bringing the action.
Waldo has that butterfly hook. He's got both of them now, able to attempt it the other direction. He was running into the cage at first.
Looks like he's attempting a footlock here.
Sanders right back on him.
Sometimes just the threat of a leg lock creates a stand-up, and I don't know how much of a threat that actually was from Waldo, but now they're in a more 50-50 position here.
Both guys have landed in this clinch. Not too much action that time, but Waldo comes out swinging.
And Sanders is always threatening that big teep.
Big knee up the middle from Sanders, comes close. Waldo needs to fix his hip position as soon as we get in that clinch spot.
After a jostle for position, we got Waldo pushing Sanders up against the fence.
Nice knee from Waldo.
Good uppercut as well.
Big right hand from Waldo as well. This is good pressure from Sanders.
Oh,
comes
knee
up the middle.
Sanders answering.
Both of these guys are just going at it.
Beautiful score from Sanders. That was good timing. Waldo selling out for the guillotine and just not enough bite on it.
Waldo's looking a little gassed out there as well.
Oh.
But he ends up on top.
Hips over into
the fight continues.
I have to hand it to these guys. These scrambles are...
What a scrap. This is insane.
It's a great
high-level scrambles.
And again, kind of back in a foot entanglement. Let's see if Waldo bites and gives up the position. If I were his corner, I would tell him, stay here.
Yeah, stay heavy on that foot and keep with the ground and pound. I'm loving it.
These are good optics, too, towards the end of the round, but...
Sanders able to reverse the position
what
yet again.
What a scrap, my Lanta.
This is an incredibly evenly matched fight between these two. And the second round is going to end with Brock Sanders on top, and very likely on top in that round as well.
I feel like that was a much closer round.
Yeah, definitely some good stuff there from both guys. Sanders had the bigger moments.
Manny Sanchez trying.
That's a huge right hand there.
Manny Sanchez trying to get his fighter hyped back up. Both guys a little tired, taking big breaths, and how could they not? What a pace this fight has had on.
Yeah.
A big left hook.
That hook was, for sure, it stumbled him, I think his feet were a little out of position as well.
I thought he threw him the double bird there for a second before he went back in.
I think that was the wobbled bird.
I think you're right, but hey, look, you got to give Sanders some credit there because Waldo felt like won that first round. Sanders definitely battling back and grabbing round two. We're in a 1-1 spot here, it feels like, going into the third round in what's been a highly competitive fight through the first few minutes.
An adjustment I think Sanders has made is he's kind of taken a beat off, slowed it down a little bit, and because of that, Waldo's kind of shifting left and right and running into some of these shots harder than Sanders is even throwing them. So good adjustment by our boy Sanders, and round three, let's go.
This fight fills up for grabs as we enter the third round.
Both guys going for a low kick. Not sure what happened there. Left hook finds its mark from Waldo.
Great return by Sanders. What a fight.
What is going on?
Got him to the mat.
Waldo with a beautiful wizard ends up on top. That's exactly what he needed there.
He's back to the big punches on the ground. I think he needs to slow it down a pace. Just try to maintain control here.
Agreed. Waldo just biding his time, trying to stay centered, keep Brock Sanders from moving his hips from left to right, creating opportunities for that guard.
Both these guys have to be extremely tired. Man, these scrambles are looking like something out of a flyweight fight. These guys have been moving so much. But, yeah, I think it's a good idea for Waldo to just kind of slow it down here, not give him a chance to hip out, to get a better position.
Just good fight IQ. The fight's been crazy and tumultuous. Let's slow it down. Let's see if we can't win this spot and leave the judges no doubt that this was our round. Slow it down a little bit. Waldo stepping over into half guard now. This is a better position.
He's doing a good job staying heavy.
just patience.
Yeah.
Rolling through these spots. Fundamentally, nothing crazy. Not trying to reach or make anything happen.
Looking for the shots when they're there and staying heavy.
Trying to step through here.
Almost going into a Waldo attempting a Darce. He's got
a good one. That's pretty deep, I think.
It is very tight. Let's see if he can finish this, seal it up. What a finish this would be for Waldo.
That's tight, guys.
And came close to tapping there for Brock Sanders. I think he's escaped it now.
He's nodding his head to the referee.
Escape by just being scrawny. Good job on Brock Sanders. Hey, that's one of those things. Sometimes that build, it benefits you. It helps you escape these positions. The more muscle you have, the more ridges, the harder it is to shake things off. Waldo attempting a Kimura, staying active on top.
This has been a great showing by Waldo here in this third round.
And it was a good submission attempt from him because it didn't pull him out of position. He was able to threaten another submission, able to threaten punches. Moved into almost mount.
This is great stuff from Waldo, just retaining the position again, getting back to his Darce choke. Brock Sanders shaking it off. Waldo continuing with the ground and pound. Waldo loses his mouthpiece, puts it back in.
and gets hit, trying to put it back in.
Loses it again.
And then maintains side control. What a scrap.
What a scrap indeed. Great work by Luis Waldo in the third round to likely secure this fight. Brock Sanders has had no answers for him in that third round. It was a great showing and really a dominant performance there in that third round in particular by Waldo.
Yeah, Waldo just being smart, winning the position. I think they both exchanged calf kicks. Yeah. Maybe Waldo's hurt him and Waldo tried. But even in this exchange, gets shook right there. Big punches finding the mark. What an even matchup. Waldo doing the smart thing. Wins the position with this wizard. Ends up on top. Rides out the round. I think that was the only clear-cut round of it. Round one was pretty close. I gave it to Waldo as well. Let's see what the judges think.
Yeah, I had it 1-1 going into that third round. I don't see how you could give it to Sanders in that third round. It was complete domination by Waldo. He had over 2.5 minutes of control time. Had a good submission attempt, threatened for a Kimura as well, and will likely have his hand raised here in just a moment. But you got to tip your cap to Brock Sanders because he was game, and especially whenever he was able to work from the outside and use that long reach of his, he was really doing a great job. The teeth kicks were on point, but in the end, we'll find out who has their hand raised in just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of fantastic mixed martial arts action, we are going to the judges' scorecard. All three judges have seen this bout the same way, therefore declaring your winner by unanimous decision! Fighting in the blue corner, Luis Mundy!
So indeed it is Luis Waldo who has his hand raised at the end of this one, and he is excited and rightfully so. What a great showing by a guy that you guys were really hyped to see here tonight.
Now you can tell it meant a lot to Luis Waldo. He has overcome a lot. I know he's a guy that's maybe doubted himself a little in the past, and happy to see him get out there and get a win. What a scrap. What a performance.
What
beautiful
a debut.
Stuff.
Yeah, keeping that in mind, that this is a guy debuting in the cage tonight. He showed an incredible skill set, the way that he was able to mix in movement on the ground, submission attempts, striking. He just did an excellent job. And both guys can be proud of their performances here tonight.